Yeah, my ambition for it was to tell a Joker story that really is a meditation on his relationship with Batman with regard to Batman's obligations to the family that he's built. I mean, the idea for the story came to me, we were pregnant with our second child. And I was thinking to myself, like, I mean, to be frank, I was thinking, what if I'm a shitty father this time around? Like, what if, you know, I don't want a kid, or what if I'm nervous, or what if I'm bad, or what if, you know, how am I going to do this? You know, the fears that all of us have, or I have, at least when we have a kid. Now he's two, and I'm very happy that I'm a dad. But, you know, I was thinking to myself, Batman has a family, and what if he has these feelings of, how do I protect them? What happens if something, you know, goes wrong? There must be a moment when he just wishes that he could stop worrying about them, and that's really what it is. I mean, it's not that I worry that I'm not a good father. Sometimes you just kind of wish that you didn't always worry about your kids, you know, and you could just take a breather for a minute and say, I don't worry about you, you know, today. I can just, like, put it aside. And that's when I feel like somebody, some villain, might hear that for Batman and say, I just heard that you wish in your head that your whole family was dead so you didn't have to worry about them anymore. And I was like, that's the Joker talking right there. He's the one that's going to come back and say, I know what you really meant. And Batman says, I didn't mean that. I don't want them dead. I love them. He's like, no, you don't. No, you don't. Because you know that in 20 years, they'll all be dead and your villains will be alive and it will be your fault. So why don't you just do them the favor of killing them right now? Because it's the kinder thing. And that's it. And really to do a story that explored that horrible question in different ways, and has Batman betrayed the family already by creating them? Is there something that Bruce doesn't want to admit about his relationship to the Joker? So that's what it's really about. It's not meant to be something that has some kind of massive, you know, sensational death or anything like that. It's really more about, for me, always from the beginning, it's deeply about their relationship and some of the horrifying truths in there.
Well, I mean, the first thing was, how do we reattach his face, you know? And so, you know, we come up with belts and hooks and fishing wire or whatever, and did what we did. To me, it was easy, you know, because I did so many years on Spawn, and Spawn was a lot of that kind of subject matter. So for me, it was like putting on some comfortable shoes. It was just a lot of fun, easy for me.
Well, Batman thinks he's dead. I mean, Batman made him... The idea is that Batman tricked him into making him drop the Joker, so that Batman assumes this fall will kill you. And he's like, I don't want to spoil it, but essentially Batman sort of tricks the Joker into almost killing himself. And in doing that, Batman thinks he's gone, but he's definitely coming back. I know when he's coming back and how he's coming back. We have a story plan, but I don't want to say when it is because I want you to be surprised. But I can tell you this, like, if the first storyline is about love, and Joker saying, you love your villains more than you love your allies, so why don't you come be with us? We love you. The second story would be about hatred, and it'll be much darker and much more vicious in that way, because the Joker will be done and will say, I did love you, and I showed you, and we all loved you, and tried to show you what was the truth, and you didn't listen. So now we're just gonna fucking kill you, and everybody you love, and everything. So it's gonna be good. Oh, well, I mean, what I would hope is that if you like my Batman, you know, or Superman, the way that I write those books is to try and put a lot of myself into them, like I just said about Joker, you know? It's personal. It's about my own anxieties and fears, and that's the only way that I really deeply believe you can make these stories for these characters that are original, is to embarrass yourself and show people the things that you stay up at night fearing and being excited about. And you don't try and just create a new villain. I mean, who cares about a new villain or a new whatever? You can't think of it as like, there's 75 years, how can I do something new? You have to think, how do I put myself into it and show you why I love Batman or more than anything else and what I'm afraid of for him? And when you do that, then it's original because it's personal. And so if you like that, my creator-owned work, like The Wake and American Vampire, are all that. They're everything that I'm afraid of and that I am interested in and excited by, American history, you know, stories hidden in the past, you know, very vicious sort of personal demons coming out in bombastic, crazy, monstrous ways. All of those things that are in that, the superhero stuff, are in there magnified in my own creator-owned work, so. just thank you, merci. I really appreciate it. I mean, I love France. My wife and I actually are really hoping to go next year to Paris. So I've been a few times when I was a kid, but I haven't been back since then, since I've been about 20. Just a year ago. No, I'm much older than that, but since then. So, you know, we really, really appreciate it, all of us on Batman, you know, on American Vampire, The Wake, Superman. It really means a lot. So thank you very much for reading the books.
Well, I'll tell you this. There, kiss on each of your cheeks. And I'll see you again someday. I don't know. I really don't know. I mean, I only have so much time to devote to conventions because I have to keep my deadlines. And the only thing I know for sure for next year, I'm going to Sicily. So who knows? I have no plans yet.